welcome. Women in Leadership is a theme this time for International Women's Day. The theme celebrates the tremendous efforts by women and girls around the world in shaping more equal future and recovery from the pandemic. For Her is an initiative by ICICI Direct that focuses on how women should take charge of their financial well-being. Dina Mehta, the first women president of Bombay Stock Exchange. Mrs. Mehta has over 30 years of experience in the equity markets, and her knowledge in stocks, investment, and financial markets is at par with the best in the industry. She has crossed many hurdles in life and has a style of her own. She has seen the evolution of equity markets and has played a very significant role in this transformation. Let's all welcome Mrs. Dina Mehta. Welcome, ma'am. Ma'am, I'm sure you must have encountered several challenges in the male-dominated industry. How did you manage to overcome them?
So, it has been a very long journey, almost 35 years that, because I entered the market in 1985. So, it's a 35 years long journey. But I would say that only initial few years are a little difficult. But after that, you know, once you get established and people recognize you, then it does not become really very difficult. So I would say that initial 10 to 15 years were very challenging, being in a men's world. And I think things are easy going so long as you are equal with a person, you know, like you are a peer. So if you are on the board of the exchange, you are another board member, people are fine with you. But moment, you know, you are one above, you know, you are first among equals, like you become a president or you go one level above, then, you know, people's swords are drawn and people, you know, they show their biases towards you and towards women also, because a lot of men do not want to have a, you know, woman whom they have to look upon for whatever interactions that they have. So I think the challenge comes only when you are one above. Till then, you are fine.
Okay. Ma'am, you have seen the evolution of equity markets from ring trading to electronic format, 15-day settlement to rolling settlement, physical shares to DMAT shares, and you have played a very significant role in this transformation. Did you face resistance from your peer group or peer members, people around you? Did people stop you from doing things?
Actually, you see, people do stop you from doing things because you encroach upon, you know, their agendas that are there and just inertia that, you know, we are used to working like this. So when you break through all those, you know, actually it's real money, you know, it's thousands of crores of rupees which are involved. So when people feel threatened like that, then they tend to gang up against you and they try to, you know, see to it that what you are trying to do, they try to trample upon you. So I feel that so long as people think that the change is helping them, then they will, you know, be with you. But moment they feel that, you know, there is some financial cost or any hidden cost which they would have to pay because of the change, then people tend to be very, I would say, hostile towards you.
Ma'am, if we talk about the Indian women are still not that comfortable investing in financial instruments, including stock market. In fact, majority of the females do it. They like to stay away from financial matters. What would you suggest them? What would your advice be?
No, I think this is, you know, my first statement always is men may be good at making money, but they are not necessarily good at managing investments or managing money. So I think this thing has to be clearly understood on investment at the same thing. According to me, women are more suitable, I would say, to manage the family finances. As it is, they manage the finances, investment. Investment is nothing but managing money of buying your groceries to, you know, attending, buying your clothes and other things. What you are buying actually is, you know, your children's education requiring some money. you want to buy a house, you have a EMI to be paid, you have a marriage coming up. So when you plan for these kind of long-term objectives of your life, then it goes into an area of managing finance, managing investments. So I think it is just an extension of whatever we are already doing. Only thing is the underlying purpose changes. Like you are maybe saving, to buy a new TV or to, you know, add some gadget, or your son is demanding a new mobile phone. So from that, you move to, I want to go for a vacation, or I want my daughter to be married. So it is just a slight shift which is there, which is the change. So I think you should keep an open mind about managing finances, and I'm sure it is the need of the hour, and it is a necessity.
The mindset has actually to change for women in India. How important is it, ma'am, for a woman to lift each other up, and what does this mean to you?
Well, I strongly believe, you know, we often feel, you know, we often say also that, you know, men should look at upliftment of women. But I think it is the women who will help the women in order to, you know, become more involved and more career oriented and become an earning member of the family. So how it goes is that, suppose in my house, if my mother-in-law, my aunt, my sister-in-law, if everybody is working, then it's a different kind of environment. Like, for example, I'm a working woman, then my daughter-in-law has a much easier thing. I can understand her work pressures and everything. So if you want a daughter to really succeed, then the mother has to provide the support. If you want the daughter-in-law to succeed, the mother-in-law, sister-in-law and others have to provide the support. Because what I feel is that the maximum change that happens, you know, in the responsibilities and of this of a woman is, first is when they get married. You know, it takes time to adjust to various social pressures which are there, social commitments. Somebody is ill, somebody got a baby. It is the woman of the house you're supposed to go and visit. There is not so much responsibility on the men. So if you say, okay, you don't worry, we'll adjust as per your office timing, instead of, you know, insisting on going on a weekday, we will go on a Saturday or Sunday, or you don't go, I will go and attend it. So, you know, these kind of adjustments, if they are made by the women in the house, then it makes a lot of difference. And then the most difficult period is the trimester of your first pregnancy. You know, that is one of the most difficult period when you are undergoing so many physical changes, new things are happening to your body. And in such a time, you are emotionally also, your quotient is, you know, very low. You are feel very weak, and you know, you suddenly feel the responsibility. So I think in that time, if support is provided by the husband, by the family members, then it is very good. And then once the child is delivered, the first year of the baby, that also is one period of very big adjustment which the mother has to do. So I think these 3-4 periods in life, if the family members, the husband and others, essentially the other women members in the family, if they can provide the support, then I feel that the career breakage which happens, you know, in most of the women when, you know, they get married or when they have their first child, you know, that career continuity would be assured. So that is very important, that, you know, in such times women support the other women who are there in the house, and they can really, you know, take them through the entire period.
Ma'am, what will be your advice to young women who are entering into, you know, wanting to make a career in stockbroking business?
No, I think it is an excellent career that one can pursue, because I always believe that Lakshmi and Saraswati are both women. So you can really, you know, tap the wealth of the stock market. Of course, you need Saraswati, you need to learn also. So wherever you are, you may have a job, you don't have a job, you are sitting at home. You know, just by following a few simple steps, you can really, start managing your family finances. Fortunately, the electronic media, the online trading platforms, everything is available on such a grand scale that it has made, you know, life very easy. Like in our time, we had to go to the trading ring in order to trade. But now you can just sit at home, you can switch on your PC, your laptop, your mobile phone, whatever, and you can, you know, start doing this thing. So you need to take some interest, you need to learn as to, you know, how to go about it, because it is not something like a rocket science. Just like everything else, investment is 100% common sense, I would say. And if we can apply common sense rules everywhere, then it is not very difficult to really, you know, start making money on the stock market.
True. Ma'am, you are an inspiration to many, including me. What inspires you and keeps you going?
No, I am a, you know, very high activity level person. Maybe that is in my DNA. So I am on the go all the time. And I am very passionate about everything that I do. Whatever I do, I believe in giving 100% to whatever mission I take up. So I take up so many missions to the sheer frustration of my husband and my family. That, you know, I tend to get occupied all the time. I just had a meeting of our society where I am, you know, looking after the repairs of the building. So many causes I take up on a constant basis because of this, you know, continuous nature that I have is that, you know, if I can contribute something, if I can help somebody, then, you know, I should be doing that. And my father also used to be like that. He was a very, very helpful person, and he was also on the go. He took up so many projects during his life and so many things that he did. So I think that we very often do not use our potential at all. You know, we are using a very small fraction of our potential, and everybody has got 24 hours. It is not as if one has more time or less time. But what are the priorities that you set in your life, and what is it that you want to do? If you are clear about that, then you can achieve a lot of things. But the problem is, most of us is we are not even aware. You know, days just come and go. You get up, some 3-4 things you are doing, you do that, then you may while away your time or whatever. But I think a lot of things can be done in 12, 15, 16 hours. And you know, and it is your attitude towards work. Like, you know, I remember one lady used to stay across my house, and if you ask her, what did you do today? If you ask me, I will say, oh, I just cooked a meal for the whole family. She will say, oh, I went to the market, I bought vegetable, I cut it, and then I fried it, then I, you know, prepared the duff. So whole step process, that whole thing goes through the mind, and you think you are doing 100 tasks, but actually you are doing only one task. So, you know, that thought process of you know, trying to manage your time, wind up things on time, I think that is really very important. And so much now, so we are so lucky that so much information is available all over. So many activities are going around us. You can join so many groups, you can do yoga, you can learn this, you can learn that. So I think that you should always target, you know, we used to have a Femina editor, one lady was there, Vimla type. And, you know, she used to always say that, you know, every year learn one new skill. Every 3 years acquire a nice asset. You must target to acquire a new asset. So you say, I will earn so much money, I'll acquire a new asset. So it may be a, you know, a new watch or a phone. Of course, now 3 years is a very long horizon. But then, you know, or you buy a car or you buy a house or something like that. So if you know, we don't tend to think. If we think that, oh, how am I going to utilize, make myself better or whatever, then I think it would make a lot of difference. You know, like for example, my, you know, daughter-in-law, she has had a baby, she's sitting at home. So I said, what are you doing these days? Aren't you, you know, she's a highly qualified pharmaceutical person. So she said, no, I have, you know, done a course on being an influencer. So she's saying, so I have done this course. So now I am an influencer for small, you know, newborn babies. So what newborn babies need, what they, you know, will eat and all that. And now so many product companies are approaching her for with products which are, you know, for newborn babies. So as her baby grows, you know, her influencing abilities will keep advancing. So that way, there are so many things But one needs to think that one should accept the fact that I can do 10 more things than what I'm doing right now. I think once you accept that fact, I think every person is same. Every person has got so much hidden talent, so much thing. Only thing is you need to light the fire. Otherwise, the social environment, the entire infrastructure available to us is so much conducive for doing so many things.
Right, ma'am. Thank you, Mrs. Mehta, for being with us. Thank you for